श्री गुरुदेव नमः स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर डिस्कसिंग चैप्टर 6 एक्सरसाइज 6.1। ऑलरेडी वी कंप्लीटेड अप टू 11 क्वेश्चन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस 12th क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर पेज नंबर 198, क्वेश्चन नंबर 12। द रेडियस ऑफ एन एयर बबल इज इंक्रीजिंग एट द रेट ऑफ द रेडियस क्वेश्चन नंबर ट्वेल्व। द रेडियस ऑफ एन एयर बबल इज इंक्रीजिंग एट द रेट ऑफ रेडियस ऑफ एन air bubble means what shape it comes to your mind? Sphere. Very good. Air bubble is increasing at the rate of 1/2 centimeter per second. At what rate is the volume of the bubble increasing when the radius is 1 centimeter, right? Again, I read the question. You see, the radius of an air bubble is increasing at the rate of 1/2 centimeter per second. So the radius, what it is given in the question, at the rate means so many times I discuss, right? dr by ds, because here it is given as, see, my cursor is moving now. You see, 1/2 centimeter per second. The centimeter is radius, second means time. So dr by dt, what it is given in the question, dr by dt, right? In the question it is given as dr by dt. Now I am going to give a solution, right? dr by dt equal to 1/2 centimeter per second. The first statement I converted in terms of the simplest format, that is dr by dt. Air bubble means, you people said, that is sphere. Here they are expecting volume of the bubble. That means you are going to differentiate volume with respect to time, right? Volume of a cube. What is the formula? Here volume is a dependent variable, time is a independent variable, right? Volume equal to 4/3 pi r cube. Volume equal to 4/3 pi r cube. Now I am going to differentiate volume with respect to time. So you see here how I am differentiating. The left hand side v is there. When I differentiate with respect to time, I arrived dv by dt, which is equal to 4/3 pi, that is constant. R cube you are going to differentiate. I told you the derivative formula, right? X power n, the derivative of x power n, on and off you have to recall the formula. That formula only we are going to use it in the whole exercise. So in the place of n you have 3. So n should be replaced by 3 into r power 3 minus 1. So you get it as 2. You are going to differentiate with respect to time on both the sides. So r can be differentiate means how it will act. dr by dt. dr by dt. Now we want to substitute the value of r and dr by dt in the right side, right? See here. And now dv by dt equal to 4 by 3 pi 3, r value is replaced by 1, dr by dt can be replaced by what? 1 by 2, right? See, everything is a multiplication. The cancellation is possible. 3, 3, cancel. Here, 2, 2. 4s are. So what you will get? 1 square is nothing but 1. So 2 pi. 2 pi. Here you are differentiating volume. So how we, what is the unit you want to write? Centimeter cube per second. Centimeter cube per second. Again I will explain the sum. You have to listen carefully, children. Right? The radius of an air bubble is increasing at the rate of 1 by 2 centimeter square centimeter per second. At what rate is the volume of the bubble increasing when the radius is 1 centimeter? The first statement I converted into the terms of dr by dt. How I convert? Using the centimeter per second, right? So dr by dt equal to 1 by 2 centimeter per second. Now you come to the volume, because they are expecting volume. Volume equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. Now I am going to differentiate with respect to time on both the sides. dv by dt, 4 by 3 pi is a constant. So it won't be affected when you differentiate, because it is a product. R cube, 3 r square into dr by dt. Now you see the r value is given in the question as 1. dr by dt, that value also you know, that you have to substitute. Finally you arrive 2 pi centimeter cube per second, the solution. Therefore volume, because you arrive the positive result, volume increases at the rate of 2 pi centimeter cube per second, right? Question number 12 is over. Next I am going to discuss question number 3. Next I am going to discuss question number, 13, right? Question number 13. See, a balloon which always remains spherical. Here also they are discussing the sphere. Remain spherical as a variable diameter. Here diameter is given to you. Diameter 3 by 2 into 2x plus 1. 3 by 2 into tx 3 2x plus 1. Find the rate of its volume. change of its volume with respect to, that is w dot r dot means with respect to x, that is the meaning, right? Here you see a balloon which always remains spherical. So here they are discussing the sphere. The find the rate of change of its volume with respect to x. Here you are going to differentiate volume with respect to x. Directly it is given in the question because they are discussing variable in the question. They didn't mention the time. They didn't mention the things in terms of centimeter per minute or centimeter per second or meter per minute like that. So variable as such is given. Now I am going to solve the problem. You have to listen carefully, right? Solution. What is given in the question? Diameter. Diameter equal to diameter equal to 3 by 2 into 2x plus 1, right? But in the formula what we had, b is equal to 4 by 3 pi r cube. That means we need the radius. That means what we need? Radius, right? See here. Radius equal to, you know the formula. The diameter means 2 times radius. Radius means diameter divided by 2. Then which implies r is equal to diameter, what it is given? 3 by 2 into 2x plus 1, the whole thing divided by 2. That means it is equal to the 2, numerator 2, it will come to the denominator. So how it will change? That is r equal to 3 by 4 into 2x plus 1, right? Radius equal to diameter by 2. That formula we learned in the lower level itself, right? Now we want to differentiate with respect to x on both the sides. X on both the sides. That means the radius they are given in terms of x. The radius they are given in terms of x. Volume equal to 4 by 3 pi. R cube is there, no? The R cube can be replaced by what? 3 by 4 into 2x plus 1, the whole cube, right? R can be replaced by 3 by 4 into 2x plus 1. Now I am going to differentiate with respect to time on, with respect to x on both the sides, right? See, with respect to x on both the sides. Now you see, what you will get, it is equal to volume equal to, that is dv by dx equal to 4 by 3 pi, that is constant. Again you are going to recall x power n, the derivative, equal to n into x power n minus 1, right? You see here what it is there, 3 by 4 into 2x plus 1, the whole cube. Now you see 3 by 4, that is a constant, a power m into b power m means a power m into b power m. That means I'm going to segregate the term. 3 by 4, the whole power 3, 2x, that is 2x plus 1, the whole power 3. 1 minute, I will change the things, right? Now you see, first I will explain. V in terms of x, afterwards I will differentiate, right? V is equal to, V is equal to 4 by 3 pi, 3 by 4 the whole cube. Now you come here, 2x plus 1 the whole power 3. Here which concept I use? A power m into b power m. That is a power m into b power n, right? Now I am going to differentiate with respect to x on both the sides. In the question itself, it is given that you are going to differentiate with respect to x, right? Now you see dv by dx equal to 4 by 3 pi, that is 3 cube the whole, 3 by 4 the whole cube, no, that can be written as 27 by 64. That can be written as 27 by 64. Then 2x plus 1 the whole cube. First you have to differentiate the power, that is 3 into 2x plus 1 the whole square, n into x power n minus 1. Here it is the advanced level. The 2x plus 1 is there. Now, when you differentiate 2x, it will come under the product of into 2. When you differentiate 2x, you will get it as 2. If you differentiate 1, it will act as 0. So, you no need to write that 0. You have to write only 2. That is understood. Now, you see 3. 3, 3 cancel. Then 4, 64. You will get it as 1 6 2 8, right? Finally, what you arrive here, you see 27 by 27, 27 by 8 pi 2x plus 1 the whole square, right? Volume you are differentiating with respect to x. That means the volume increases because you arrive the result as positive. You arrive the result as positive. So you have